Hello! This video tutorial will review interpreting and navigating the Climate Studio results panel after running a LEED version 4.1 option 1 daylight simulation. In the previous video tutorial, I showed you how to set up your simulation inputs. Now I'll press run again and the CS results panel will automatically open. Note that Climate Studio 2.0 is an order of magnitude faster than 1.9 due to parallel CPU utilization, improved algorithms, and the removal of pass-based calculations. When 100% is reached, each sensor has been calculated using 6 ambient bounces and 4,096 rays. From the outset, a dashboard with 5 key metrics is presented. This design has earned us 2 credits, with a spatial daylight autonomy (SDA) of around 70.5%. The SDA variable is a percentage of regularly occupied floor areas that are daylit, in this case the areas that meet LEED's target illuminance levels of 300 lux using daylight alone for at least 50% of occupied hours. The temporal graph visualizes this daylight autonomy throughout the time of day and day of year. If I click on an occupied floor area in the room table, the graph updates to reflect the statistics of that room alone. The Rhino model will also update to visualize only that room. By hovering over a single sensor with your cursor, you can see the data of that specific sensor. The room table contains statistics such as the size of the room, spacing of sensor points, whether the room has blinds or dynamic glass, and all of the core metrics from the dashboard. In this scenario, the annual sunlight exposure, ASE, is around 25%, which is quite high, especially in the southern area of the office space. ASE represents the percentage of regularly occupied floor areas that are overlit, specifically those locations receiving direct sunlight for more than 250 occupied hours without the use of dynamic blinds. One of the consequences of high ASE is that the blinds get lowered more often, and this actually decreases available daylight in these rooms. For example, clicking on a southern window group will update the results panel to display the percentage of the time the shades are up or down. We can see that the shades are closed for a little over half of the working hours. For this reason, LEED daylight reporting requires that ASE values above 10% be justified in writing. However, a better solution would be to take the high value as an indicator that a change in design is necessary, either by adding fixed shading or adjusting the facade design. In the previous video tutorial, which set up our simulation parameters, I used the base case design of the office space that used a curtain wall type glazing facade. Let's see what happens when we run the simulation again, but instead use the option 1 design. First, I'll rename this result to base case. Then I'll navigate back to the Rhino Layers panel, turning off the base case and turning on the option 1 design. As you can see, this design features a shaded facade around the perimeter of each window. Additionally, the option 1 design glazing is clearer than the base case, which is a design strategy used to maintain daylight levels while increasing direct shading. This is thanks to smaller apertures and more depth. Back in the CS Workflows panel, I'll press run again. Now that the simulation has completed, I'll change the name of this result to option 1. I can now click between each result to quickly compare the metrics. This time, our ASC has reduced significantly to below 10%, and we have gained 1 LEED credit. Additionally, the blinds are now open for a larger percentage of the time compared to the base case scenario, and overall, daylight availability has increased. The option 1 design is the clear winner. I can now export a PDF of the LEED report directly within Rhino. Click on the PDF icon in the top right corner. The US Green Building Council has accepted these reports for compliance with the LEED version 4.1 Daylight Option 1 credit when uploaded to LEED Online. Let's quickly open the PDF report. The first page provides an overview of the whole model, along with the core daylight availability metrics. The following pages list each occupied area with its respective results. Lastly, the appendix contains information on the software simulation settings, layer materials, window groups, and occupancy schedules. Thank you for watching and happy simulations!